do. Light curtain. Phony next. Doom. Shit, how many doors is that? Four? Yeah, I guess it's four. See if doing that does me any good. A little bit more time to... Does not appear so. Give it one more shot. Yeah, no, that's just letting him get off the first hit. So let's try three. Okay, so that let me get two off. Shit, who did he, edge? Another one. Oops. Making toast! Butter and toast! And that's... empty door... or just door number 5. Got to get Bio off before you killed her. Gotta wonder if there is some strategy I'm not aware of. Blaze seems to favor the front row. Some strategy I'm not aware of for killing these doors better. Light sword! But... oh, it's close. Oh, I'll let Kane get up on this since he's been, oh wow, not doing well with his axe. That is pretty good. Kinda weird, Kane can use swords, but Cecil can't use spears. Marriage. surprised. Ho-hum. Wow. That is helpful and good. Wait, did she do 1,000 too? Alright, let's hold off on that for now. Oh. I didn't walk into there with my pants around my ankles. Dimension 9. Why they called it that? Hey, something different. Oh wow. Thunder. That's the lightning version of Blaze. And gain the level. Twisted Turn. Hellwind Shuriken. Like her aim. Oh my. Evil head. Wait, they're either weak to fire or they absorb fire. I cannot remember. Let's find out. Alright, let's not give it in. Neither. Blood sucks. The hell? Five. six, seven, eight. This is 9, and that will be 10. Damn it. Now that he's got that better sword, jumping with him is gonna do me better. I think so long as bio or the jump connects, it's possible that it won't have a monster come out of its face. Just get rid of these. Just slowing me down. That sucks. Do it. Levels all around, and there's levitate. Or float. Kotetsu. Again. Ooh, Dark Hood. Vitality went down by 2, strength went down by 2, but agility went up by, I forget how many. Alright, so... Here you go. Have a hat. So we're 10 doors in. 10 soul-eating doors in. Miss Vamp. What's the other one that was actually clever? Draculady. That was it. 11. Oops. Sucks. Oh, my eyes dry. Seemed like it did a lot of damage. Smoke bomb! That's good to have. Ether. Ahead. Get out of here. Yeah.
doors are we at? 11? Heaven's what we're going with. Butter nuts. Going. That worked out fairly well. Nothing. Wait, was that 11 or 12? I'll call it 11. Yay, four levels. Yeah, see, if I skipped this, I would have had to grind somewhere else. Butter giblet. Going. Young Ben's sources of frustration. As soon as we get to this door. Rather out of it. Aww. Monster. Why are you leaping out of doors? Oh. Excuse me. Crystal room. Wait a minute. I'll have to go back and check, but I swore when I warped and got it. Wait, actually? Isn't that where I save state Earth? No, it's not. Well, in that case, let's make a backup save there. Just in case I screw up something with this one. But yeah, I swear when you teleported, when you did the warp glitch to get the crystal, that it gave you like a blue crystal, like it was like it wasn't an underground crystal, it was an above ground. Well, the item description is the same. I have a potion. I wish this auto sort was a bit more comprehensive. Level I was when I came in here. Nah, I didn't even keep track of how many doors I went through. I think it was 15. It's the number I'm going with. Never fail, something has to go wrong. Hey Edge, what were you saying about being able to smell traps a mile away? Shut up and help me destroy it. The wall is closing in. So, despite you have a finite amount of time, and if you don't beat him before a certain point, he just crushes the whole party. Instant death. Slow. We're doing good damage. That's not good. I wonder if... custom games are gradually affected by. You know, they have to undo something. That wasn't it. Oh my. I haste, but they do. Who should I give it to you? Yeah. Except we're not doing anything else. Damn it. Got rid of all my boxes this morning. Uh-oh. See the other end of the wall. Alright, he's too close for my comfort. Crash down. Crit? No. Man, I really thought I would make it. Good enough. A pathetic trap. Probably wouldn't have worked if I didn't throw that berserk on at the end. Conversely, if I had done it sooner, probably would have killed it before it started crushing us. Probably could have preserved more people. Alright, so can't teleport. Can't warp in this room. Couldn't work in that room. That little line running up the screen, that's, you're only seeing that because the emulator. Like, that's not an intended effect. But not Kane. This is why it won't let you warp out of this room. What the? Come back to me, Kane. Bring the crystal and come back to me. Govez! Kane, hang in there. I'm alright. I'm no longer under his control. Doink! That sting, though. Bastard! Kane, what are you doing? Again, you underestimate me.
But it is of no consequence. My long searching has come to an end. The Tower of Babel will now open the way to the moon. Come, Cain. Cain, wake up. Cain, ow, what bit me? Now we have all the crystals. The way to the moon will open. Wait, damn it. Fwahahaha. Way to the moon. And that is where we are going next. Hang on a minute, actually. Okay, so I guess we're doing this. Wait a minute. Tucky Rose, huh? Hey, Kakuro. Not making any... alright. So I gotta go off and come back down first. Well, let's go tell the king that all is certainly lost. Bad guy has all 8 crystals. Oh, you've returned. The last crystal. You couldn't protect the crystal. What? You had one job! We've lost. Our only hope is the legend of the magical ship. Literal Deus Ex Machina. It was a huge ship used long, long ago. Is this legend? One born from the mouth of a dragon. That's the legend written on my sword. Isidia, it's a town of mages in the overworld. It actually exists? Yeah, dude. The village elder said he was praying for my sacred light. The legend on my sword. Could it be that it's trying to revive the magic ship? Yes, that's exactly what he's doing. Mysidia, you must hurry to Mysidia. The way to the surface is closed. And with all the crystals gathered, we can't get near the Tower of Babel. Babel. Can't do anything without me, can you? Sid! Ouch! I'll attach a drill to the nose of the falcon to get you out of the surface. Are you better yet? No time to be worried about an old man's injury. Can you really do it? I can put up with you. I sure as hell can put a drill on an airship. Let's get to work. It's even relevant, like, where the sprites are standing. They're hooking a drill. Why is Edge just looking away? Your ship, isn't it? It's definitely better without dialogue. Just having them run around back and forth. We'll leave it up to our imagination. All that arguing just to get you to bedonk on one thing. Uh-oh. There he goes. Sid! He got tired. Really overdone it this time. Can't fight with you, not with a beat up body like this. All I can do is fix airships for you. Jeez, old man, I salute you. Get well soon.
Take care of Cecil and Rosa. Leave that to me. You just get some rest. Leave that to me. Doesn't make me feel any better, Edge. Cecil, be careful. Get well soon, sir. Stop talking. Keep that airship as if it were me. Don't let me down. Thought it said don't let it down. It's sweet. Okay, so a couple of stops, and then I'll cut it. Just curious about something. In Final Fantasy 1, there's this like glitch spot on the map called the Peninsula of Power. And in later iterations of this game, they make a Peninsula of Power on this island. And the Peninsula of Power is, it's just somewhere to grind and level that's like better than everywhere else. It's better because the monsters are leveled up. Yang is dead? Yeah, right. He's not someone who dies easily. No, he's not. Wait, really? I gotta go to him twice? Is that what you're telling me? Alright. Baron, or no. Yeah, here first. That is cool looking. There we go. I always thought you'd be able to land on it. It looks like you could land right on top of it, right? Wait. I can only hit that right pixel. Fucking... Wait. No, I guess that's... There's no getting in the middle of that. Alright. So we need this boat now. So we can... Oops. Ah. Take this. Put it here. Hope that's not in the way. Adamant Cave. My father found a strange ore over here. His hobby is collecting animal tails.
Who are you? Go away.
You have a tail, though. That's another story.
How convenient.
This is the rat's tail I've been searching for. Alright, I'll give you a little bit of this ore. So, the rat's tail is an item that... So they use it in the after years. Theodore is sent to go on this like quest to, you know, to earn his place in the Red Wings. And he has, you know, his quest is to go to this cave and retrieve some mysterious artifact from inside. And the artifact just winds up being like a rat's tail, a mummified rat's tail. And it's just for proof that he did it. You know, it's not worth anything itself. And I did not need to get the red ship, I just like it better. But I don't like it without the drill. I am a child. Things like that matter to me. I'm not making any more swords. I'm making more swords. Hey, that's my sword. I'm back with my sword. Master's really busy. I'ma be a smith as good as the master. Think if you've done that soon, don't be impatient. So, you're supposed to... I don't know, I've heard that you can do stuff to things. Now, I really lost my train of thought. I was stolen, and then the act of stalling made me forget it all. Oh, right. So, you know, I was under the impression that after you give him the adamant, that you have to go further the quest a little bit, for lack of a better term. But, you know, I've read and I've been told that you can just, you know, like, go sleep in a tent a couple times or something, or fight a few battles, and that will push the time forward. So we're gonna do this cave and see if we're actually able to do it without furthering the plot any. Actually harder than the cave to the Fame Arch. And I am low on potions again. This cave is all sorts of like secret, hidden things every friggin' where. And I always get confused as to navigating it. I think you get those on the way out. Oops. Sprite layers to make it so that I can see. No. Wait, really? No, that's not gonna help me. Fairy rod. Wait. I gotta have one of those. Yes. I do. I put one.
Mall ball.
Wizard Malboros. Digestive fluid. So that's like almost every status ailment you can get. And that wing is because I'm floating. Uh-oh. They turn you into frogs. Wait a minute. What the H? See, that would have taken me forever to figure out. Oops.
Touched me, and it's still doing it.
Where are you? And now two of us are unfrogged. I guess these guys aren't doing that much damage, or any damage really, they're just making it really annoying to kill them. Yay! And then when it's only her, she turns herself into a frog. Do I have any maiden kisses? No, I don't. I do have the spell toad, though. Oh, come on with that. I didn't realize... Whatever, man. I knew she turned herself into a frog, but... I did not know that she would then... start casting frog on us. Alright, goddamn frog. Berserk. Oh, that was good. I
Benzojamin levels. The hell was on me? God, I don't feel safe now. Bug flew in and touched me. And it kept touching me, and it was like, it was a big bug. It was like a cricket-sized thing. Now I don't feel safe. The light's off, so I can't see anything. Also, I have to wear sunglasses indoors, so that makes it even harder to see without the light on. Seriously, I can see the TV and everything else in the room is just straight up black. Surrounded in pure darkness. Man, these treasures suck. Well, great. So the top three are Red Fang, White Fang, and Blue Fang, which are like really strong fire to they're items that cast a strong fire, strong ice, and a strong lightning to everybody on the opposite team. Cecil actually had and used one in the beginning of the game. He used a Red Fang. Difference is that it's ranged.
so I could put him in the background and do the same damage. I know in the DS version, you can put him in the back row, and as long as he has one throwing weapon equipped, both of them will do range damage. Don't know if it's the same here. And I don't care enough to test and figure that out. Wait, what am I doing? Seven to strength, 10 to agility, and plus 2 to the multiplier. Went from a 9 multiplier to an 11. Battle power did come down a bit, and also it's two-handed. 122. I don't know, we'll let him try it out for a minute. See how it do. Alright, that weapon is gonna cause him to be in Berserk, so he's just gonna always attack. Ooh, that is pretty good. Not good enough, I don't think. Oh shit. I'm out of room. Made one space. Yeah, it's good. Centipedes. But these are very easy things to kill. See? Way easy. Medusa. Probably why. Alright. Cottage. Now let's go down a different path. You have to do that every time you go through like a ladder, steps or whatever. Centipede! $1,000 and a cottage. Oops. Oh no. That is not good. Damn it. There we go. Let me just do that, because... Oh, there we go. Okay. Just gonna do this. Because I never wind up using these. I guess white would be lightning. Red spire, blue would be ice. Because items don't care what you are. Other thing. Ah, there it is. Mage Mash. Does extra damage, yeah, to like magic based enemies. Why? But why though? This way. And I think there's... I might be missing a couple of things, but... I will... get the next third time I have to come through here. Oh. lives here?
Fairies.
Humans! What are you doing here? Get out now! So these claws belong to somebody. Who's that handsome young man? We won't give you Yang. We found him collapsed outside of our hole. He hasn't awakened. We've been tending to him ever since. Is our love not enough? Yang, wake up. See, I should have been able... I thought... when we talked to Yang's wife the first time... apparently we had to see that... like, proof of life, if you will. Let us make sure I do. A space. Yang, he's underground. So that's where he was. Oh, these onions making my eyes water. He shouldn't be miserable like that. Please, give him a good whack with this. The frying pan of love. Frying pan. Alright. I gotta go sell some shit. Make room. Say this to everything. Yeah. All them cool tattoos. As sure as that I thought I'd be able to throw, but I can't. Guess that's good enough. We got the fry pan. I gotta wake up Yang with it. We've slept, did a bunch of fighting, and we did the Silph Cave. Now we're gonna do it again. But this time it'll be quicker. We already did most of it. Spots seem to do 50 damage per step. Okay, don't want there. This would be 200. I wish there was a spell that would turn off random encounters. Oh, Jesus, I'm gonna navigate my way through all this. Elfin bow. 41, 20, 55. Alright, so this is a bow for a black mage. This bow gives you 10 to strength somehow, which is incredible. Alright. That's what's through there. No. Yeah, see, this is where I get confused. Hey, I figured it out. Uh-oh. Light, ice, fire, ether, my potion. And now just motor on through. God damn it. This little side quest that we're doing is the one that I miss most frequently. Because I friggin' do it wrong. Because I think if you go and move the plot forward after this point, you won't be able to get the frying pan. Like, she just won't give it to you.
Ah, stop!
Bonk. Is it time for training already? Let me sleep a little longer. Oh, that's sweet. His wife wakes him up with a frying pan. Sir Cecil. Yang. I'm so glad you're safe. The sylphs pulled me from the jaws of death. Thanks to you, the giant gun was destroyed. I'm going with you. No, you have to sleep. The fate of the world hangs in the balance. I cannot just lie here. This isn't a place for a wounded guy like you. Who are you? I'm Edge of Elben. I'd be a lot more useful than you would. A ninja. I'm coming too. Don't be ridiculous. We'll help them. This person's a summoner, right? She'll be able to call us. We'll fight in your place. Pleased to meet you, Miss Sylph. So, I guess we proved ourselves to the Sylphs by getting Yang. So wait, he just never is gonna say anything again for the rest of the game? What would you do if Yang died? Humans are so violent. Don't take Yang away, just leave Yang to us. And we're done with him there. I'm gonna give you one last chance, old man. You're dicking me around. Oops. So maybe the 10th thing works if you've already advanced the plot when you come and do this. Alright, so I ended up filling up the rest of this episode. So we'll cut it and come back. We will visit the moon. Peace.